In this paper, viscocapillary instability in cellular spheroids by Mathieu Martin and Thomas Risler, we study the stability of cellular aggregates in culture, also called multicellular spheroids. When such cellular aggregates are grown in a culture medium, they tend to reach a steady state size, limited by the finite diffusion of metabolites. Here is depicted a characteristic concentration profile of metabolites within the aggregate, diffusing from the outer culture medium. Yellow depicts the highest concentrations and blue the lowest. At steady state, the distribution of cell divisions is inhomogeneous. Dividing cells, as depicted in red, are preferentially close to the outer surface where the metabolite concentration is high. Cell death, however, as depicted in yellow dashed lines, happens mostly in the center of the spheroid where the metabolite concentration is low. As a result, a permanent cell flow exists from the outer surface to the core of the spheroid. This is due to the fact that dividing cells push the other cells inwards until they eventually die and break apart. In this paper, we investigate the potential instability of this spherically symmetric steady state. The origin of our proposed instability can be pictured thanks to this schematic drawing. The original spherical surface of the aggregate is depicted by the external blue dashed circle. The inner circle indicates the positions of two points, A and B, at a given distance from the unperturbed outer boundary. When this spherical geometry is perturbed, for example with an increased thickness of the cell layers above A, the cells located in A are pushed inwards by more layers of dividing cells between them and the surface than those located in B. These differential flows create internal stresses within the aggregate, which resist the inward motion of the cells located in A. This in turn slows them as compared to one would expect without this resistance. As a consequence, the cells located close to the surface above A are pushed outwards, which amplifies the original perturbation. Modeling the spheroid tissue on long time scales as a viscous fluid, we can study this instability. Here we can see the results obtained with a linear stability analysis in spherical harmonics on using physiological parameters. We report on the left the mode growth rate omega as a function of the mode number n for four different steady states coded by different colors. A given mode is linearly unstable when omega is positive. The stationary radius is largest for the results represented in blue. On the right, we display a schematic representation of the deformations associated with each mode. We can see that, with this particular set of parameters, an instability arises at finite wavelength for the modes around n equals 3 or 4. This occurs at a spheroid radius of about 530 microns, associated with the green diamond set of points. We have shown that multicellular spheroids can be spherically unstable in their shape while keeping an average constant size. A domain to which we can speculate that the present mechanism applies is the evolution of microtumors after a period of dormancy. The proposed instability could be triggered by the long-time evolution of some parameters, such as cell-cell adhesion strength or metabolite supply. While our model does not address these long-term evolutions, a microtumor could still be unstable by the mechanism proposed here.